sleep on that couch myself.
Oh, I'm sorry. You should have said something.
I did, but you were snoring.
No more apple juice.
Really had a taste for some apple juice.
Can you share?
Might as well. You took the soap up.
Sitting around the kitchen table, guess you could say this is our day together.
Okay.
You know, it's been about 4 months since I first met you, and I don't really have the feeling that I know you.
Clay.
See, you are funny. You have this way of making people laugh. I admire that. You know, Dr. Huxtable, I really, really love your daughter. And I want you to know that this is a great family to live with, and I really appreciate everything you've done for us.
Really?
And I want to apologize once again for marrying your daughter without you knowing about it. I'm sure it came as quite a surprise.
Surprise? I was shocked. I didn't even have a chance to reject you.
You would not have rejected me.
I suppose I'd have had a shotgun and I said, don't come through this door.
I would have said, open fire. You can take my life, but you can't take my love.
Very good. You knew my daughter only 2 weeks and you got married. Now, in the course of that 2 weeks, did,
I don't know if I should be sharing that with you, Dr. Huxtable.
Yes, you should.
When I first met Denise, I was very attracted to her because she is hot. I mean, no disrespect intended.
Sorry, just watch your mouth.
Okay. All right, anyway, I can't believe I'm telling you this, yeah. But...
you should.
I really wanted to... express myself physically with her. Can I say that?
Yeah, but you're borderline.
Okay. But you'll be happy to know that Denise was having none of that.